Welcome to This Morning on Asakhe Podcast, your daily dose of insightful conversation on current affairs, politics, and social issues. Please share and also follow us on social media at SiteZW. Now, stay tuned to today's episode.
A very good morning to you and welcome to This Morning on Asakhe. We look forward to a great discussion with you. Good morning, Brighton.
Good morning to you this morning. Good morning to you guys. Thank you so much for joining us again as we wrap up the week. Today, looking at SADC region now, South Africa to form a government of national unity. Last night, Cyril Ramaphosa, the president of ANC, announced to say they're going to form a GNU with other political parties in parliament. That's going to be interesting as we go to the next few coming weeks on what to see. Who's going to be part of this cabinet? Who's going to be premier of this area? Who's going to be speaker of parliament and so on. So it's going to be an interesting one. He spoke largely about the issue of parties coming together to work together to form a GNU. He says, we have therefore agreed that we invite local parties to form a GNU as the best option to move our country forward.
Mm-hmm.
So that for me, GNU. Remember when 2013 with the GNU in Zimbabwe. But I'm looking forward to see what kind of a GNU is going to be formed in South Africa. You know, Ramaphosa spoke about engaging the DA, EFF, IFP, and the PA. They're still waiting to engage the MK as well. But I'm looking forward to hear to see who's going to be the Speaker of Parliament, from which party, and also who's going to lead these different portfolio committees. And also, I'm keen to see who's going to be president of this coalition, of this GNU.
Mm-hmm. And I'm keen to see Brighton. What this GNU is going to bring for South Africa. Mm-hmm. We saw what our GNU brought for Zimbabwe. Well, how is it going to turn out for South Africa?
Yeah.
Looking at the state of South Africa at the moment, mm-hmm. all the grievances that South Africans have brought to the table. Let's hear from Sivas. Good morning, Sivas.
Good morning, Brighton. Good morning, Nontlahla. I think the basis of this GNU is not on the basis of the will and of the need. It's all because of a fractured political outcome, in the sense that there was no party that managed to get the outright majority. It will be very, very interesting to see the latest political developments, because you'd watch a lot of fractured people. If I was to look at certain parties like the Patriotic Alliance, certainly, besides chasing away foreigners, what more ideologies are they most likely going to bring to the table? Which is certainly nothing. So I'm not too sure if that government of national unity is going to last. And also, one other consideration that I managed to pick is that the Umkhonto-we-Sizwe party, from the way that they've been sending their own signals, is that they would like Cyril Ramaphosa to step down so that they can engage the African National Congress. And the ANC is very adamant that any resolution that requires Cyril Ramaphosa to step down is not going to be accepted. So just because of such kind of differences and all, I don't foresee the possibility of that GNU working out in the long term. Anyway, that is my contribution.
Well, thanks so much, Silva, as well, for that contribution. It's quite interesting what you are raising there. But I saw Julius Malema tweeting, I think today, about the GNU. Says, no, we're not desperate for these positions. Why is ANC dictating on what we should do in terms of elections? South Africans gave them a warning signs, right? But now ANC is detecting on what should be done. I don't know what that means, coming from Julius Malema, the leader of the EFF. Good morning to you, Nkala.
Good morning, Brighton. Good morning, Nontlahla. It is an option that is there in the Constitution, and it is an option that is different. In South Africa, political leaders, most of the political leaders are going to be in parliament, because of their system of election again, which is different from Zimbabwe. The system of election is a party nomination list, which usually begins with the leader of the political party. So all political party leaders will be in parliament. And that means all the agendas are in parliament. And in South Africa, no one is yet elected a president. So there is no one with the power of sweeping over others. In 14 days, they have to create a government. And that means he who is to create the government needs to be careful, because the constitution has put up nuggets and areas that they have to respect If they don't, after 14 days, they lose the chance of forming that government and then opening up to other options. There is a minority government. There is the chance of sitting even in the opposition. So in actuality, a South African constitution balance is what Zimbabwe lacks if we were to compare the two. But for South Africa, it is a well-balanced constitution, which is, then it leaves a lot in questions for us. We had a good constitution in 2013. But a constitution is not good if it is not managed, especially by people that we call legislators. The difference in Zimbabwe is that a member of parliament and the legislator is our problem. Because our members of parliament just become members without much of understanding what they are. They don't become legislators in terms of understanding balancing legislation, which is what a democracy becomes. That's our major problem. But for South Africa, it's well balanced. Whatever they are going to go through, whatever hurdles they have, the constitution guides them in everything they do, number one. Number two, ANC as a political party is a broad church. Their consultation system they used yesterday tells us that political parties can differ, but can discuss and can still at the same time come up with a center point and work, whether they differ, whether they are known that Cyril and Lindiwe Sisulu are not good friends. Lindiwe Sisulu is allowed to say whatever she says without being fired from ANC. Thank you very much.
Well, thank you so much, Ankala, for that.
Yeah, let's move on to the next speaker. Good morning to you, Njabulo.
Good morning, Brighton and Nonchancha. What ANC is looking for, it is looking for a political party to coalesce with so that they can form a stable government. Because what has been happening, Brighton and Nonchancha here, when they were trying to form the local government, it's been a mess. You look at Jobek, their coalition with DA has been falling apart. You look at them here in Eguruland, their coalition has been falling apart because through 2-3 months, they are electing another mayor. And now people were saying to them, whoever you are going to go into a coalition with, please be sure that you create a stable government. And I think this is why Ramaphosa has gone out and said, let's form a government of national unity. So that they bring in even smaller parties, so that even when one pulls out, the numbers still remain for them to continue in government. And I think they are not only looking to say, let's meet the 50+1% to form the government. They are looking to say, let's get everyone on board so that even when one pulls out, we still remain with the numbers to continue to run the government. Because it's going to be a mess if you have one partner and then that partner decides to pull out today and you get another one, they pull out tomorrow. It will bring instability into South Africa.
Thank you so much, Anjabulo, for that contribution. Yeah, accountability, Brighton, yeah. And, all eyes on South Africa.
For me, I'm looking forward to see a genuine way they're going to be working together. Remember, I went about voter last week, right? They were voting for jobs, voting for better living conditions, they were voting for land and so on. Even this issue of Eskom, they're voting for proper service delivery and also living conditions. So, yeah, I'm hoping to see parties that are going to work together. Good morning to you, Ndlovu.
Morning, Ncube. Morning, Sis Nhlanhla. I was just saying that it's an interesting development which is happening in South Africa here. Mina personally, I would like to commend ANC for their maturity, for them to sit as the national executive and say, okay, the best way forward for this, let us propose a government of national unity, something which might work for the country. Reason I'm saying so is that we keep on referring to say that ANC is trying to copy the GNU which we had in Zim in 2008. We must not forget that the GNU which we had in Zim was imposed on us by Isedic, via the stewardship of Thabo Mbeki. And some of the people, some of the so-called excellencies were dragged kicking and screaming to the negotiation table. They didn't want or tolerate the idea of a GNU. So, I think East South Africa is positioned to implement this and, see it to its better end. But also my highlight of the day yesterday was Thuthuzile Zuma, when they were protesting outside the venue where the NEC was holding their meeting. Thuthuzile Zuma, must not forget that she's the daughter to former President Jacob Zuma and former Minister Nkosazana Dlamini Zuma. She was protesting and she was carrying a banner which was written, Jacob Zuma is a sellout. It was interesting, but again, it's politics or politics as they may call it. But once again, my point was just to come and say that the GNU, which we keep on referring to in 2008, some of the people were dragged to the table kicking and screaming. Thank you, Breton.
Well, thank you so much, Ndlovu.
Yeah, I was watching one of the TVs in South Africa this morning, and then one of the reporters was saying, ANC tried to call the MK leader, Jacob Zuma. Zuma said, no, don't call me, I'll call you when it comes to this negotiation. It's quite interesting there, what's the MK factor when it comes to this GNU. Will the MK also join this GNU? Remember, Ramaphosa spoke about the DA, speaking to the EFF, speaking to the IFP and the PA.
Mika, good morning. Please wrap up the space for us.
Firstly, on the issue of corruption in South Africa, saying the EFF and ANC, they are looting in Pietermaritzburg, wherever they are. But the thing is, in South Africa, the reason why people don't trust the DA is simply because of apartheid. We don't know what the white people, what people would do to black people once they are in power. So the people in South Africa, those, the old Lindi Wesisulus of this world, they know the scars of the apartheid system. And I believe it's almost 30 years into democracy and the scars are still fresh. For black people to continue to be turned now to say, let's trust the white men to lead us or to be among us, I think it's too much to ask. So for me, I lean towards Lindy, where those guys who say we should lean towards a black coalition rather than a GNU. Why? Because South Africa, if you look at Western Cape, you go to Khayelitsha, Guguletu, life there, yes, if you go to the affluent area, the southern suburbs, it's perfectly nice, good roads and stuff. But if you go to the township, life there is different. We talk of the sheikhs and stuff and everything. Even the fires, have you ever had fires that happened in Cape Town way by the whole sheikh or township burned down? But that doesn't happen in white areas. So South Africa is at a crossroad, and I don't believe the GNU is the best way forward for now. If there's anyone who's going to be saved by GNU, it's not the people of South Africa, but the ANC. It's a moment. What it does, the GNU is going to destroy opposition in parliament. There's virtually nothing to oppose because everything there is going to be every party is going to take responsibility for everything. So there's not this good, the opposition will die in South Africa. And the last thing that we don't want to do is to see something more of a one party state whereby we have a coalition where people agree on everything with nothing to oppose. The reason why the malemas of this world, even the DA, it's where it is because of its opposing power. That, antagonism that it plays on ANC, and it is actually shaped the development in South Africa. Look at what happened to Nkandla, even the Palapala issue. It was, had it been that they were in government of nation, I don't think those things were going to be raised. So for me, a GNU, no, I would rather want to see a coalition where we have opposition in South African parliament. Thank you.
Well, thank you so much, Mika, for wrapping up the show.
Yeah, I've come to the end of the show for this morning. From myself, Brighton Nube.
And Nonhlanhla Mapikwa.
Bye for now.
Thank you for tuning in to this episode. For feedback, you can contact us on 263-777-47-0017. Don't forget to follow and like our social media pages.